All right, everyone, so I'm getting ready to edit my intro video, so I wanted to kind of record this and take you guys through the process in case anyone was interested on how I ended up getting with the final product that you've seen on iTunes U. So I'm going to go ahead and open up iMovie on iPad, which is stored right here for me. It's going to take us to this project palette here, and from here we're going to hit the plus button in the top right corner to open or start a new project. It's then going to give us an option to either create a movie or a trailer. Go ahead and select movie. And it's then going to let us choose from any of these marvelous templates down here. So I'm just going to keep on this modern template. So in the top right, I'll hit create. And now, again, this will take us to this three-pane window of, in the top right, we have our media library that houses all our videos, our photos, and our audio options, whether that's music or sound effects or things like that. In the bottom of the screen, you will see our timeline, which is where we're going to drag all of our media into to kind of edit and create our project. In the top left is our viewer, so that's going to show us what our project looks like as we're putting it together, so we can preview some of the effects that we're doing, or text, or titles, or things like that. So the first thing I always like to do is drop in a little soundtrack for us to edit to, so I'm going to select theme music here. And there's a bunch of preloaded ones on here. You can also choose stuff from your iTunes library if you wish. Let's listen to some of these. So if I go ahead and hit play, it's going to let me preview that selection. Not bad. Fun. So I like that. It's 59 seconds. I'm going to go ahead and hit the drop down arrow. So that way I can put that in my timeline. And you'll see it'll drop right down in there for me. And if I hit play in the timeline, it's going to play through it. There's a couple setting things I like to do while I'm working. One is there's this little waveform indicator here in the kind of middle of the screen on the right side. And that just lets us see our audio waveforms. Also, if you click this gear in the bottom right corner or cog, it gives us some more options here. We can kind of put a filter over the whole project, change the theme if we don't like the theme that we've selected. We can also add the specific theme music that goes with that theme. But one thing I always like to check is fade in from black and fade out to black. And this just gives us a cleaner start and stop to the project. So let's close that. So now that we have our music in place, I'm going to go back to my videos here on my media library. I'm going to select recently added. That'll show me some of the recent videos I've recorded here with my iPad. And I'm going to select this 57 second video that I recorded for my intro. I'll hit play so we can preview it.
Don't turn it on me.
All right.
Aaron giving me a hard time.
3, 2, 1. Hey everyone, I'm Scott Nelson with The Ohio State University. I'm an educator.
Excellent. So I don't want those first couple seconds there, so I'm going to grab these little yellow bars here, which tell iMovie where I want the clip to start and stop. And once I have that selected, I'm going to hit the drop down, and it's going to drop it into the timeline for me. So I have my interview in place. You can see it's about 51 seconds long. I'm going to go ahead and click on this clip because I want to adjust the audio level. So once I select that clip, you'll see in the bottom left I have some settings I can choose from. I'm going to click this little speaker, which lets me control the audio. You can see right now the audio for that clip is turned all the way down. I'm going to slide this bar all the way up to about 200 so you can hear me nice and clear over the music. And so now if I play.
Originally from Akron, Ohio, now been in Columbus for the last 2.5 years.
Excellent. And you can see that fade in from black there.
I'm Scott Nelson with The Ohio State University. I'm an education technology specialist that'll be working with the College Ready Ohio program.
All right, so I want to add a kind of a title slide so you can see my name and information. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this clip. I'm going to go over to these scissors here and select those. And then once you select those, you'll see in the bottom right side, it's going to give us a couple different options. I'm going to select split, and it's basically going to cut this clip right there like a pair of scissors. So now I can select this first clip. And I want to add text over that clip specifically. So I'm going to hit this T at the bottom, which gives me some text options. Here is kind of the modern template. We can do like an opening, a middle, or a closing. I'm going to go ahead and do this opening here. And I can type in my name. Done. So it has my name and title there for you to see, and you'll see it'll fade out.
Originally from Akron, Ohio, now been in Columbus for the last...
All right, so I don't want you guys to just sit there and watch a talking head for the whole minute, so I want to throw some photos and some video over top of me talking. Now, one of the things or drawbacks about using iMovie on your iPad is you can put video over top of video, but for some reason you can't put photos over top of video, which I don't quite understand, so hopefully we can send some requests over to Apple to see if they can fix that or adjust that. But essentially, if I try to put a photo in right now, it's just going to put the photo right here at the beginning of this clip, so I can't put it over top of this. So, but a little work around this is if I select this clip, go to my scissors, and hit split again like we did for the text, I can now kind of work around this. So let's
Originally from Akron, Ohio, now been in Columbus for the last 2.5 years. Really excited to get out to a lot of the school districts and start working with you guys. My background's in multimedia, video production.
So I want to put photos over all of this video here.
Classes or projects, don't hesitate to reach out to me. I'll be excited to work with you and give you some tips, tricks, pointers, or even problem solve anything that you're running into. So.
All right, to there. So again, I'm going to select this, hit split. So this whole piece in the middle here, I want to put photos over. In order to do that, I need to get rid of the video that's in there. So to do that, we're going to hit detach here at the bottom right. That's essentially going to get separate the video from the audio of me talking. So if we watch this.
Akron, Ohio, now been in Columbus for the last 2.5 years.
So I should be able to start dropping in some... photos here. I have a photo of Akron here. I want to drop in because I'm obviously talking about Akron. I want to drag this audio clip back over here.
Akron, Ohio, now been in Columbus.
So still a little bit of a skip there. Let's see how that goes.
Actually from Akron, Ohio, now been in Columbus.
All right.
Akron, Ohio, now
right. Been in... So that's a little bit better. I can probably put that cross dissolve back in here now. Let's see what that does.
Originally from Akron, Ohio, now been in Columbus for the last 2.5 years.
All right. And so now I can actually edit this a little bit for my start and end point. So I want this photo to kind of just pan. So we'll have it start there. And then we'll have it end there.
Originally from Akron, Ohio, now been in Columbus for the last 2.5 years.
All right, I'm going to shorten this clip a little bit because we only talk about Akron for a moment.
Akron, Ohio, now been in Columbus for the last...
All right, so now let's put this photo of Columbus in here. We're not going to talk about Columbus that long, so let's shorten that up a little bit to match.
Originally from Akron, Ohio, now been in Columbus for the last 2.5 years. Really excited to get out to a lot of the school districts and start working with you guys.
All right. Let me shrink this down a little bit. So this is that video that I said we need to get rid of. So we can go ahead and hit delete. It'll knock out rid of that. But I still need to continue to add photos here. To fill in this blue gap. So you can see I want photos over all of that blue audio. So let me go ahead and here's some goofy photos I took. Just for fun. Some selfies. All right.
2.5 years. Really excited to get out to a lot of the school districts and start working with you guys. My background's in multimedia, video production, so if you're looking...
So I can maybe add some... Let me delete this. I can maybe add some photos of some of the media stuff that I've done here. Some good ones. Here's some of that. I'll do this one. All right. So I have a little too much, so I need to trim these down a little bit. Whoops. Let's make this one just a little bit longer. This one just a little bit longer. This one just a little bit longer. All right, so let's see what we got here.
Excited to get out to a lot of the school districts and start working with you guys. My background's in multimedia, video production, so if you're looking to get more media into your courses or your classes or projects, don't hesitate to reach out to me. I'll be excited to work with you and give you some tips, tricks, pointers, or even problem solve anything that you're running into. So hopefully that gives you a brief introduction into myself. And hopefully this will give you a good sample of what you can do with your intro to post in the discussion board here in iMovie. So good luck. Have fun with it. No pressure. And I'll be...
All right, cool. So this last part, I want my email to come up. So I'm going to go back to text here. And let's see if we can find something here to put my email in. That's a good one. So we'll put my name once again. Done. And let's put my email here for you to reach out to me. ELSON.1004@osu.edu. Done. All right. Actually gonna change this.
You and give you some tips, tricks, pointers, or even problem solve anything that you're running into. So hopefully that gives. Excited to work with you and give you some tips, tricks, pointers, or even problem solve anything that you're running into. So hopefully that gives you a brief introduction into myself, and hopefully this will give you a good sample of what you can do with your intro to post in the discussion board here in iMovie. So good luck, have fun with it, no pressure, and I'll be excited to see what you guys have.
All right, there we go. So we got a little 50-second project. I'm going to watch this all the way through once just to make sure it's good to go before I export it.
Hey everyone, I'm Scott Olson with the
And that's it. So about 15 minutes, we took our simple intro video and really spiced it up quite a bit. I would recommend, if you really want to do something a little more advanced like this, to maybe try it on your Mac laptop or desktop within iMovie. It's a little bit easier to do. But if you don't have that and all you do have is the iPad with iMovie on it, then it is definitely possible. Again, putting video over top of video is much easier. You don't have to worry about doing that detaching audio piece that we did here. But it's just kind of a component I wanted to share in case it is something you want to do. It is possible. You just have to do some work around it. So now that it's done, we're going to go ahead and go back here. I'm going to select, change the name within the project. Scott's Welcome. All right, so now from here, I can upload this to YouTube. So I'm going to go ahead and do that and hit upload. I'm going to change the category to education, just because that's my go-to. I'm going to upload it to HD quality, and I'm going to keep it as unlisted because I only want you guys to watch it. And since I'm going to be sharing the link with you, that'll be fine. So I'll hit share. It's going to go ahead and process, compress, export, and upload this video for me. And probably in about 10, 15 minutes, it'll probably be available on YouTube for me to go ahead and copy the URL and paste into the discussion, which you guys got to watch. So hopefully that helps you kind of show my process on how I put this all together. And if you have any questions, just let me know. You have my contact. Thanks.